Is coffee a poison or is coffee a medicine? Can it aid in improving your health? In this video, I'll tell you all about coffee, scientific evidence, myths, and what's not. Does coffee harm the thyroid? Can coffee reduce the risk of cancer? Does it improve the heart or worsen it? Let's talk about coffee. And what is the dose of coffee? These studies were done with doses of 3 to 4 cups. For filtered coffee, you can make a maximum of 4 cups, with each cup containing around 200 milliliters. If it's espresso coffee, from 3 to 4 shots of 50 milliliters per day. Because a cup of filtered coffee and a cup of espresso have the equivalent of 100 milligrams of caffeine. So these studies imposed a limitation on the caffeine dose, capping it at 400 milligrams. Important this, because I'll discuss effects later, so note that. That said, what are facts about coffee? Number one, drinking coffee can decrease the risk of developing type 2 diabetes by up to 33%. A study discovered that individuals who consumed coffee up to 4 cups per day experienced a decreased likelihood of developing type 2 diabetes. Does this mean that coffee will eliminate the risk of you getting diabetes? No. I'm not stating that coffee is the cure for diabetes, but rather that individuals who consume coffee have a reduced risk, a decreased likelihood of developing type 2 diabetes, which is highly significant. Ah, but if I drink more than 4 cups, is there an additional effect? The studies did not guarantee this safety, so I am limiting the dose to up to 4 cups per day. Number 2, coffee and cholesterol. Can coffee potentially increase cholesterol levels? If it is filtered brewed coffee, this does not happen. The studies did not show this. But why are people saying that? Because if it is espresso coffee, individuals who consume more than 5 doses of espresso coffee, once again, I am emphasizing here the dose, because it is important that you know this. So after 5 doses of espresso coffee, an increase in bad cholesterol, LDL, of 6% up to 8%, was observed in studies. So filtered coffee does not raise cholesterol levels, and consuming espresso coffee in larger quantities, exceeding 4 cups, specifically 5 or more, can lead to an elevation of 6 to 8% in cholesterol levels. Number 3, the consumption of coffee can enhance production capacity, as well as augment concentration capacity in individuals. This is already well researched. It is one of the most extensively studied effects in the medical literature, so this is true. Coffee is an excellent ally, not only in the workplace, but also during physical exercise. For example, coffee has the potential to improve your mood and also enhance your physical performance, making it a valuable companion for both work and workouts. Yes, it is indeed true that coffee has the ability to alter the patterns of sleep waves. People who consume coffee in the evening. Specifically, studies have shown that this effect occurs if you consume coffee after 3 p.m. So not necessarily in the evening, but if it's in the late afternoon, this also happens, that coffee can decrease deep sleep waves by up to 20%, which is very significant. So if you are going to consume coffee, restrict your consumption until 3 p.m. in order not to negatively impact your sleep. Coffee has the ability to interact and obstruct a specific type of receptor known as adenosine. Number 5, coffee and heart. Coffee possesses the potential to diminish the risk of heart disease, as it may lower cardiovascular risk if you consume up to 4 cups of coffee on a daily basis. In fact, coffee can even reduce some types of cardiac arrhythmias. Well, but they told me that coffee increases the chance of you having a cardiac arrhythmia. After administering coffee a total of 8 times, we observed this pro-arrhythmogenic effect. The chance of arrhythmia increases, but if we consume coffee dose, I mentioned there are over 8 doses available. So if each cup has an average of 200 milliliters, you have to drink more than 1 liter and 600 milliliters of coffee per day to have this pro-arrhythmogenic effect, to have a greater chance of having an arrhythmia. So you agree that it is a very high dosage? But in the right dosage, coffee can decrease the risk of different heart conditions and even cardiovascular risk factors. The risk of experiencing a stroke, for instance. So it is worthwhile for you to consume coffee for the sake of heart health. 6. Scientific studies have shown that consuming coffee regularly can decrease the risk of depression by up to 40%. A study evaluated people who drank coffee up to 4 cups a day and compared them to people who did not drink coffee. And the group that drank coffee had a 40% reduction in the risk of having depression, which is very significant. And you, do you notice any change in your mood? Do you get more open, jovial when you drink coffee? I sense this contrast. Hence, that's why I put this item here too. And I wanted to ask, do you drink coffee? What dosage? Do you have a preference for espresso or filtered coffee with a filter? Personally, I prefer espresso. I consume a total of 3 to 4 cups of espresso on a daily basis, without fail. You inquire a great deal, do these advantages additionally pertain to capsule coffee? Or what about instant coffee, also recognized as granulated coffee? I am uncertain of the exact reasons why the studies place greater emphasis on filtered coffee and espresso coffee. So these benefits may also be applicable, but I have no means of communication in this context, relying on scientific studies. Consuming coffee can worsen the symptoms of gastrointestinal reflux and gastritis, making them more severe. If you have any of these situations, you will need to refrain from consuming coffee, as it can exacerbate even in small amounts. Drinking 1 cup of coffee daily may worsen reflux symptoms, so it's crucial to avoid coffee in this situation. The 8th topic, coffee and pregnancy. Is it safe for pregnant women to consume coffee? Caffeine is able to pass through the placenta. Therefore, it is recommended to restrict coffee consumption to a maximum of 150 milligrams, equivalent to approximately 1 cup or 1 shot of espresso per day. More than that is not safe, and coffee is also associated with certain adverse effects in excessive amounts. So I recommend that if you are planning to have coffee while pregnant, you should restrict your intake to just 1 serving per day. Number 9, coffee and cancer. Several studies have demonstrated that coffee can potentially reduce the risk of developing various types of cancer, including prostate cancer, liver cancer, bowel cancer, endometrial cancer, and even melanoma, a type of skin cancer. Simply by consuming coffee, you have the ability to decrease the likelihood of developing cancer. No, 10. This info will be of interest to many. Coffee and fat in the liver are noteworthy. Studies have shown that coffee can help reduce inflammation caused by liver fat and hepatitis due to its anti-inflammatory properties, antioxidants, vitamins, and minerals. Therefore, there are specific studies on the relationship between coffee, liver fat, and inflammation caused by fat in the liver. And then you inquire, does decaf coffee have this impact? I cannot assure, because the majority of the extensive investigations were conducted with coffee, with caffeine itself, not decaffeinated. No. 11. Is it true that coffee can lose its nutrients if it is not stored correctly? Yes, it is true. You have to be careful with 3 things. First, with oxygen, with air. So it has to be in a closed jar or in the coffee bag itself, because it can oxidize and lose, yes, a good part of the nutrients. This is not a myth. This happens. You also have to be careful with the light. Brightness can also harm the coffee. Then in a dark jar or in the coffee bag itself. And the third thing you should be aware of is the level of humidity. Therefore, avoid storing coffee in damp locations. Oh, and what if it's in a vacuum? If it's vacuum sealed, then you'll protect it from moisture. So even if you leave a damp place, it won't harm the coffee. But who keeps coffee vacuum sealed? Less than 1%. Do you keep? I don't think so. I don't keep it. But if you retain it, be aware that it possesses this additional factor of protection. Number 12. Coffee can decrease the absorption of iron and calcium. This statement is accurate. If you consume coffee immediately prior to meals, or during meals, or even shortly after meals, individuals who have the practice of consuming coffee shortly after lunch, for instance, can potentially disrupt and diminish the absorption of calcium and iron. This is generally not an issue for most individuals. However, if you suffer from iron deficiency anemia, caused by a lack of iron, this may have an impact on you. Or if you have osteoporosis, have low levels of calcium, or even if you are taking calcium, coffee can additionally decrease the absorption of this calcium, so you have to be cautious in certain situations. But I absorb a lot of iron, my ferritin, the iron stock is very high. The doctor even told me to have coffee with meals or even a little before. Now, this is true. There is also this beneficial effect. We theoretically use a negative effect, which is to decrease iron absorption for a health benefit. So people who have very high ferritin, who absorb a lot of iron, this can also be a strategy. Number 13, coffee and thyroid. Why did I choose to focus on this particular topic? I want you to pay close attention to this. Coffee does not cause any type of problem in the thyroid. It does not cause hypothyroidism, even nodules in the thyroid. But if you have an excess of thyroid hormones, either because you are treating hypothyroidism and have elevated hormone levels, or because your thyroid is producing too much T3 and T4 in the case of untreated hypothyroidism, or when you have not yet been able to stabilize hormone levels, in this case, consuming coffee can exacerbate the symptoms of hypothyroidism. So specifically in this situation, it is interesting that you do not consume coffee or any other stimulant, such as black tea, for example. You already have an excess stimulus. If you take another stimulant, it may not be good for your health. After considering these facts, what is your opinion on whether coffee is good or bad for your health? Personally, I think coffee is a great ally to our health. You can help and contribute in various situations. Just have to be careful with the dosage, as I explained and always emphasized in this video. Please rate on a scale of 0 to 10. If it's 10, I'll create additional videos similar to this one. Include city, world, region, and country in your comments to specify the location you are referring to. I speak from Porto Alegre. It is extremely important that you drink coffee without sugar. Can you do it? I solely consume black coffee. If you cannot, I will provide a suggestion. It is a video where I discussed 8 tips for you to stop consuming sugar. In this video, you will find numerous helpful tips to reduce sugar consumption. Sending a hug and looking forward to the next time.